Hi, welcome guys. Today we are going to talk about HTTP and its usages. We will see its past, present, and what is JSON, what is lookup in that, and REST calls. What are different type of REST calls? So let's begin in this journey. Hi. So now we are going to talk about what is internet and how it came to be and how it is used. So internet was created in 1991 with the concept that two computers can be connected and information can be transferred within each other. And soon internet evolved into something which is what we see today, where there is a computer which is connected to a lot of data centers around the world, and the information is stored and calculations are done in depth. Only thing which is done in our browser is to show information in front of us. Earlier days, the information was transferred through basically whole complete web pages were sent from server. Earlier they started from static ones, then it came to something called as AJAX call, where part of information was sent from server to UI and it was rendered. Those AJAX call, the earlier information which was sent to server and brought back was based on SOAP, which is like a stateful simple object access protocol, where basically it was in an XML format generally. Guys, taking a pause, please think about giving a like to this video because it really helps me to reach more people and help them. Think about subscribing if you want to keep hearing me because I post video every day. Let's now continue to the video. What is XML basically? In XML, you have different tags as an HTML. In HTML, you have head, then you have body, and then you have div, p, span, lot of things. In XML, you can write your own custom tags, you will define the schema, and then you can have value inside it. With XML, the data was quite secure and transferred, but over time, things evolved into, with the REST coming into picture, JSON was introduced. As you can see in the image right now, you can think as XML calls or SOAP calls as things which are moved inside an envelope. An extra parcel is created over that, and a JSON is like a postcard, direct information. It's just you can send a string across, you can send a JSON object across. A JSON object is like a JavaScript object. A JavaScript object, when you write, you can basically have an array inside it, but you only limitation which you have in JSON is basically you cannot have methods written inside it. You can have variable keys and then values of it. Values can be string, array, object, complicated nested object, whatever you think you can write in JavaScript object, you can do there. And most of the browsers right now, most of the browsers and server and everything can process JSON strings into a JavaScript object, or the objects used by their own libraries inside server. Like in Java, you have different libraries to pass that, like JSON parser. So what is REST? REST is basically representational state transfer. It's a way of sending information which is quite optimized, thinking about the size and performance of it compared to XML. It is in JSON format, information is sent and brought back. Also, you have different type of calls which you can do in REST. That's like get, put, post, delete. Most of the cases, in most of the places in my organizations, wherever I have worked, we generally work with get and post. Get is something where in the URL, whatever you are, basically you can ask server for some information and server will return data. You don't send much information to server. All the information which you are sending to server can only be part of URL, whichever you are sending to server. So consider your web server where you are calling is google.com/api/get profile picture. then in that URL you can append something. This is not an exact URL which you can call to, but this is an example kind of thing where you can make a call to server and get the information. Let's go into code and we'll see all the different REST calls and different type of things we can do with them. Right now we have I have created already in a small application where we have ng on it, lifecycle hook attached, and then we are going to make some HTTP calls. As I said, HTTP call is basically REST calls have four major things. There is http.get, and then there is this .http.post, right? And this will show some error because we are not sending information. And then there is this .http.delete, then there is this .http.put, and then there is something called as this .http.patch. These are generally used, but in most of the organization, even out of these, only these two you will see as usages are done on these things. Post is why, what is difference between get and post? In get, what you do is you basically call some server path. In post, what you can do is, so you can write a URL in that, and then the second parameter is you can send any JSON object to server, right? So there is a difference. This will send a JSON object to server, and in get you don't send any information. The only thing you have to send information to server is basically your URL. In URL you can write some variables. We'll go into details in some other day, some other video. But in post call you can append a basically object. You can write anything in the object. There is one more thing which you should know before REST and Angular way of using HTTP is about headers. Whenever you make an HTTP call to server or when server returns data, there is a term called metadata. It's data about data. So let's see one example. So when we make any HTTP call here, like consider we have done this XHR, if you click in the network tab, you can see all the calls you have done to server. So in this you can see headers written here. Even though I didn't write any header while doing the get call, you can see a lot of things will be automatically appended in this, like accept, which kind of information I can the browser will be accepting, what kind of connection is that, with what was the host, and lot of things. And similarly that to that, server also sent some information back to our UI. You can access those headers, or you can set some custom headers to be sent to server. These custom headers can be used for authentication and stuff. One JSON is basically full form is JavaScript object notation. This is like a JavaScript object with exception of method name, and you have generally key and value pairs. You can have key as any name, any string you want to give, and value as anything which you can think about, like a number, boolean, object, array. As you can see here, a lot of things has been done here, right? What is lookup? This is called lookup. Basically you are looking up into JSON JavaScript object and getting the value from some property name. You can either use this thing, or you can go ahead and use the named bracket, the square bracket thing to get the value here. So we can use either this or this. We just remove this data thing. So you can get in values from here too. So let's see our console, and you can see the value 2 is printed. Either in this way we can do, or you can do in with dot name example. Just let me like this and save it. And then we'll go towards this screen, and you can see 2 is printed. So that's all about JavaScript, little bit about REST and JSON. Thank you. So guys, thank you for watching this video. It will really help me if you can just subscribe to this video by clicking right here or here. There is a button for subscription. It really helps me to create more content like this. Have a nice day and see you tomorrow.